Lonnie, Mick, Mark, and Jimmy. How you guys doing?
Nice to be here.
You guys came in from LA?
Yeah,
right.
LA.
And good flights and everything?
Nearly died.
You nearly died?
I missed the plane. These guys had a good flight. I missed it. I had to take the next one, so you know how that goes.
Yeah.
It's been a storm.
Yeah. So you guys are from LA, and you're on. I'm trying to get at a question here about the way you guys rehearse, because I know that you have very interesting rehearsal space.
We're beyond that now.
Yeah, that was the past.
It wasn't Jimi Hendrix.
Tell us about the past.
This was the piss room, the world famous piss room.
The world famous piss room.
Old dilapidated building in South LA with bums used to sleep and everything.
Why did you go there? Why were you there?
Breeds character, man.
Yeah.
Along that path.
People were living there, and you just played.
Well, they didn't live there after we moved in.
Yeah. We didn't blow them out with the sound.
Absolutely.
Yeah, they had to leave.
They had to leave.
So actually, there's like a railroad that used to go through there. There's a railway.
Yeah.
There's actually people, homeless people, that still sleep there and stuff. And this building that where we did rehearse that, they slept there.
Now, how did you get anybody down to see you?
Ted Templeman just drove down there and showed up one day.
No, I got a photo. Down to this one guy named Happening Dave Kaplan, who was our manager.
And he got Ted Templeman down there to see you.
He got six labels in like 7 days down there, major labels. And it's really good.
They loved it.
And how did they respond to this room? I mean, they didn't run away?
They held their breath.
Loved it.
I can just play a couple songs here. If you don't dig it, see if someone else is coming in.
Absolutely. We didn't sit there and go, do you like us? You okay for this movie?
Yeah.
And you guys are just playing two songs. What do you have to give to us? And they said, well, we got to do this. We'll see ya. Next! So we finally came in, and Warner Brothers was the right thing for us, because
the phone lines are burning up. People out there in America want to talk to you.
Okay?
So let's take that
phone. Flying phone lines.
Hi, young man. Talking with Bullet Boys.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Thank you for using AT&T. What's your name? These are real tough questions. Your name?
I was just wondering how you guys got to know.
Basically, what's the name of this?
Won't tell me his name.
Oh, bro, what's your name, man?
I'm from Bayside.
Who from Bayside?
Matt.
Matt from Basin. Now, was that so tough, Matt?
Hi, Matt.
Hi, Matt. What up? Hey, dude, we got our names. Basically, Bullet Boys. We've been shot full of holes throughout our whole career. People telling us that we couldn't make it. People telling us that we couldn't get a record deal. And we just called ourselves Bullet Boys because we wanted to be on the charts with a bullet.
Yeah, we got to grow up and it helps. It makes sense. Believe us.
Hi, Yanni. I'm Bullet Boys.
Hi.
Hi, who are you?
This is Amanda.
Hi, Amanda. Where are you from?
How about North Carolina?
Okay. You have a question for Bullet Boys?
Well, actually, I just like to tell Mark that I think he's absolutely gorgeous.
Halibut, North Carolina? Is that what you said? Halibut, North Carolina?
For the halibut?
Havelock.
Okay. That's good.
It's a bit different, though.
What's the next song you guys are going to do?
For the Love of Money.
For the Love of Money. Is that something about your lives?
You just feel it very strongly.
You love money. Okay. Thanks, guys. We're going to set up with the song.
Yeah.
Boys, we'll be back.
Hello.